morning students, here we come up with a gross anatomy lecture of nerve supply of the heart. So therefore, in the nerve supply of the heart, we start with definition. The entire nerve supply of the heart is supplied by cardiac plexus. So this should be there. Cardiac plexus is our terminology. And the cardiac plexus, there are two cardiac plexuses situated in the gross anatomy of the heart, superficial and deep cardiac plexus. We have to discuss our entire short note on nerve supply of heart depend on the cardiac plexus. So therefore, these two cardiac plexuses will be superficial cardiac plexus and there will be the deep cardiac plexus. Now, these plexuses are formed by, each plexus will be formed by sympathetic and parasympathetic nerves. Parasympathetic supply will be from vagus and sympathetic supply will be derived, as we are going to discuss, from the sympathetic chain. So therefore, each plexus is formed by sympathetic and parasympathetic components. Then, this entire nerve supply of the heart, as is regulated by the cardiac plexus, which is composed of sympathetic and parasympathetic components. Now, the location, we start from the location, which will be known as situation, then how it is formed, which is called formation, and then the branches. So each and every plexus, we are going to discuss 3 points. And those 3 points will be the situation. First point will be the situation. Second point will be the formation. And third point will be the branches. Once you complete these 3 points of each and both the plexuses, our nerve supply will be complete. Here, we start with our basic, what is plexus? The plexus is nothing but it is a collection of nerve fibers and various nerve cells. So it is a plexiform network of nerve fibers and nerve cells which will constitute the superficial and deep cardiac plexus. So therefore, continuing with the superficial cardiac plexus, we will take this much. We will draw a line diagram, and on this line diagram only we are going to draw the formation, situation, formation and the branches. And it is the most easiest way to understand and remember. So first we draw, we take this much as the heart. Now here we will take the border of the heart, and here I will reduce this so that we should be able to, and inferior border we are going to draw the base, and here this is the left border, and therefore here we are going to prolong this like so. It is right auricle and this is left auricle, and these are the grooves. So basic sternocostal surface, very simple. And then we are going to draw the first structure here, and that will be the pulmonary trunk. Please draw this pulmonary trunk, and this is how we show the basic pulmonary trunk, which will divide into right and left divisions, right and left pulmonary branches. Above that, we are going to draw the cross section as we have drawn previously, nothing new. This cross section in which we are going to show in this way the right and left posterior aortic sinuses. This is the aorta and anterior aortic sinus. From the anterior aortic sinus, we are going to show this coronary artery, right? And from the left, we are going to show this anterior interventricular as well as the left, that is the circumflex branch in this direction. So pulmonary trunk, aorta, nothing new, right coronary and the left coronary. Similarly, what we are going to show on either side will be, with the help of green color, we are going to show here on the extreme right side of the right atrium, we are going to show here this as the right lung root, right lung root. And at this side, left to the left atrium, we are going to show at this level the left lung root, left lung root. So pulmonary plexus we are going to show on either side. Now as the base is complete, now we are going to show the aorta. The aorta we are going to mark in this direction. So please mark the aorta in this direction. We are only going to show the sections and line diagram. So this will be the aorta. here the aorta, arch of aorta will be complete. And we are going to show just about that. We are going to show with the help of violet color the division of trachea. So we are going to show here the division of the trachea. This is where we are showing this division of trachea. This division of trachea, it should be at a lower level, because basically just for the sake of clarity we are showing. Otherwise this division of trachea will be situated deep to the arch of aorta. But here we just want to show the clarity. So this is the division of the trachea. Here this tracheal division is complete. Otherwise deep to arch of aorta will be the division of trachea. So these are the line diagram, the basics which we have drawn. Pulmonary trunk, aorta, arch of aorta, division of the trachea. This is the right and the left auricle, the right coronary, left coronary, and the right lung root and the left lung root. Now here we start with the superficial cardiac plexus. In the superficial cardiac plexus, the situation, first point is, remember, as I told you, situation of superficial cardiac plexus will be, it will be located just beneath the arch of aorta, first location. Second location will be here. We start with the superficial cardiac plexus, which is located just beneath the arch of aorta. Second location will be, it will be located on the right side of ligamentum arteriosum. So please draw here ligamentum arteriosum, just to signify it is on the right side, ligamentum arteriosum. So this superficial cardiac plexus is on the right side of ligamentum arteriosum. And the third situation will be, it will be located in front of right pulmonary artery. So this will be located in front of the right pulmonary artery, superficial cardiac plexus. These three locations, these three situations, points of situation are very important, because they are asked in MCQ. The location, the situation of the superficial cardiac plexus. Once again, I repeat, it is located below the arch of aorta, on the right side of ligamentum arteriosum, and anterior to right pulmonary artery. Note down, this is the situation of superficial cardiac plexus. Now formation, very important. Formation will be, we are going to draw the incoming lines, incoming arrows. In the formation, only two arrows we have to draw, because the formation is from two structures only. Superficial cardiac plexus, the formation will be, you draw an arrow coming from the left side. So please draw from the left side one arrow. And this arrow is coming from left superior cervical sympathetic ganglion. So the cardiac branch coming from the left superior cervical sympathetic ganglion is one formation. So here I am going to draw this ganglion. And this ganglion is the superior cervical sympathetic ganglion on the left side. And therefore, we are going to mark alongside with it also the left superior cervical ganglion of the sympathetic chain. So this is one formation. Second formation will be, you bring this formation from this side, from lateral side, and you draw a nerve, and this nerve is the left vagus nerve. So please draw this left vagus nerve, mark it as the left vagus nerve, and the branch which is coming from the left vagus nerve, this branch is the lower cervical cardiac branch of the left vagus nerve. So please note it as lower cervical cardiac branch from the left vagus nerve. There are two cervical cardiac branches, two cardiac branches from the vagus nerves, from the right and the left vagus. This is the lower cervical cardiac branch, which will form the superficial cardiac plexus. And another branch is the left superior cervical sympathetic cardiac branch, or cardiac branch coming from the left superior cervical sympathetic ganglion. These two branches will lead to the formation of superficial cardiac plexus. Please note down. So here I am going to mark this as superficial cardiac plexus. Very simple, two branches. Now, after formation, branches. What will be the branches of superficial cardiac plexus? The first branch will be, you pass this branch upwards in this direction. That will go to, here I am going to draw the two right and left half of the deep cardiac plexus. So this is the deep cardiac plexus, which is situated in front of bifurcation of trachea. So therefore, this branch is going to the deep cardiac plexus. First branch going to deep cardiac plexus. Here I'm going to mark this as deep cardiac plexus. This is the first branch. Second branch, it will go to the left, left anterior pulmonary plexus. So here I'm going to show the branch going to the left anterior pulmonary plexus. Branch going to the left anterior pulmonary plexus. And the third branch will go to the right coronary plexus. So please draw here. This will lead to the, here, this is the right coronary plexus. So I'm going to mark here, please mark this as the left anterior pulmonary plexus. Here, I'm going to mark this as, please mark over here, this as the right coronary plexus. And I'm going to mark this as already marked deep cardiac plexus. So therefore, these three are the branches. The three branches of the superficial cardiac plexus, branch going to the deep cardiac plexus, second branch going to the left anterior pulmonary plexus, and third branch going to the right coronary plexus. Superficial cardiac plexus is over. We have discussed in the superficial cardiac plexus, what we have discussed? We have discussed the situation, then formation, then branches. Now the formation is from the three branches. Formation is from two branches, left superior cervical sympathetic ganglion, and another branch is the lower cervical cardiac branch of left vagus nerve. Branches are three. What are those branches? Deep cardiac plexus, left anterior pulmonary plexus, and the right coronary plexus. Now we come to deep cardiac plexus. In the deep cardiac plexus, the same points will be considered as superficial cardiac plexus. So therefore, we start with the situation, then the formation, and then the branches. So this is how we will discuss the deep cardiac plexus. Very important. Once again, we come on this direction. Please come towards this diagram. Here we are going to discuss the deep cardiac plexus. Situation. This deep cardiac plexus is located in front of tracheal bifurcation. Point number one. Point number two in situation, it will be located deep to the arch of aorta. Here we have drawn the arch of aorta slightly at a lower level so that we make this thing simple to understand. So that is why the arch of aorta we have drawn at a lower level. Otherwise, the situation, second point is this deep cardiac plexus is located deep to the arch of aorta. And third point will be, this will be located, the deep cardiac plexus will be located above the bifurcation of pulmonary trunk. This pulmonary trunk, where it bifurcates into right and left pulmonary artery, just above that is the location of deep cardiac plexus. So please note down the three points about the three points about the situation of superficial and deep cardiac plexus. Once again, I'll repeat the situation. In the situation of superficial cardiac plexus, which already we have discussed, it is located just below the arch of aorta. First point, second point, right side to the ligamentum arteriosum, and third point, it is located in front of right pulmonary artery. Same thing goes about the deep cardiac plexus, three points. The three points are in the deep cardiac plexus. The first point is the location that is in front of the tracheal bifurcation. Second point about the location situation will be, it is located deep to the arch of aorta. And the third point will be, this deep cardiac plexus will be located just above the pulmonary trunk bifurcation. So here, the situation of deep cardiac plexus is over. Now we come to the formation. Formation is very interesting, and this formation will be, first we draw, we complete the ganglia on either side. So here I am going to draw, as I have drawn on the left side, the right superior sympathetic ganglia, the right middle sympathetic ganglia, and the right inferior sympathetic ganglia. So the three ganglia I have drawn. Same, the three ganglia I am going to draw here on this side also. The three ganglia, this is the inferior, this is the middle, and this is the superior sympathetic, cervical sympathetic ganglia. Two nerves we have to draw, and the two nerves will be here. This is the right vagus nerve, there the left vagus nerve, which we have drawn. And similarly, we are going to show the recurrent laryngeal nerve. So we are going to draw, here we are going to draw just besides the recurrent laryngeal nerve, just besides recurrent laryngeal nerve. And we are going to mark here, so it will be easy. So here we are going to mark the right vagus nerve, and here we are going to mark the right recurrent laryngeal nerve. Very simple, do not complicate. And these three, they are the ganglia which are going to mark superior, middle and inferior cervical sympathetic ganglia. Very simple. On left side, this now we already marked left vagus, and here this will be the left recurrent laryngeal nerve. Very simple. And similarly, we are going to show the T1 to T5 thoracic sympathetic ganglia, both on the right and the left side. So we will mark 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in a condensed manner. And in a condensed manner, we will mark like this: 1, thoracic 2, thoracic 3, thoracic 4, and thoracic 5. These are the sympathetic ganglia. T1 to T5 sympathetic ganglia. Similarly, on this side, we are going to mark here 1, then 2, then 3, and then 4, and then 5. So these are the thoracic sympathetic ganglia on either side, right and left side. And we are going to mark here these three ganglia, we are going to put accounts and mark it as the thoracic sympathetic ganglia from T1 to T5. This is what we are going to mark. T1 to T5, the thoracic sympathetic ganglia. On the right side as well as on the left side. Left side also we are going to mark here T1 to T5 sympathetic ganglia. So now our basic is complete in the formation of the deep cardiac plexus. Now in the formation of the deep cardiac plexus, we are going to join. Please note down and join. Deep cardiac plexus is formed by so many branches. And what are these so many branches? They are, keep on noting down, keep on writing down. Number one, branch coming from the right superior cervical sympathetic ganglion, the branch coming from the right middle cervical sympathetic ganglion, the branch coming from the right inferior cervical sympathetic ganglion. Similarly, on the left hand side, the branch coming from the middle cervical sympathetic, left middle cervical sympathetic ganglion. Similarly, the branch coming from the left inferior cervical sympathetic ganglion, but it will not include this, no, because from the left superior cervical sympathetic ganglion, it is going to the superficial cardiac plexus. So except the left superior cervical sympathetic ganglion, it will receive cardiac branches from all the remaining cervical sympathetic ganglia. Next, here it will again be formed by the thoracic sympathetic ganglia, right and left side, T1 to T5, which already we have drawn. So you draw the branches which are coming from the T1 to T5 on the right side. Cardiac branches from T1 to T5 right side. Same way, the cardiac branches which are coming from T1 to T5 from the left side. So therefore, the deep cardiac plexus will also be formed by the cardiac branches which are coming from the right and the left side of the T1 to T5 thoracic sympathetic ganglia. And then finally, it will receive parasympathetic from vagi. So parasympathetic fibers will be from the vagus. Now remember, from right and left vagus, there are two cervical cardiac branches, upper cervical cardiac branch and the lower cervical cardiac branch. From the right vagus, it will receive number one, upper cervical cardiac branch, and number two, from here I am showing lower cervical cardiac branch. Upper cervical cardiac branch from the right vagus and lower cervical cardiac branch from the left vagus. Similarly, it will receive one branch from the right recurrent laryngeal nerve. So it will receive one cardiac branch from the right recurrent laryngeal nerve. Now we come to the left side. On the left side, it is going to receive from the vagus only one cervical cardiac branch. And which cervical cardiac branch? The upper cervical cardiac branch from the left vagus, because the lower cervical cardiac branch which we have drawn here is going to the superficial cardiac plexus. So exclude that. only the upper cervical cardiac branch of the left vagus. And from the recurrent laryngeal now left side, only one cardiac branch from the left recurrent laryngeal now. This entire network completes the formation of the deep cardiac plexus. Once again, I am going to repeat the formation of the deep cardiac plexus. It is going to be formed by the cervical cardiac branches of sympathetic ganglia, cervical sympathetic ganglia, on the right side superior, middle, inferior, and on the left side only the middle and inferior. Similarly, it is going to receive cardiac, is going to be formed by the cardiac branches from the T1 to T5 sympathetic ganglia, both on the right and the left side. Very simple and very easy to understand. Similarly, it will be formed by the cardiac branch, upper cervical cardiac branch and lower cervical cardiac branch of the right vagus now, as well as the cardiac branch of the right recurrent laryngeal now. And also it is going to be formed by the upper cervical cardiac branch of the left vagus now, not the lower cervical, and the cardiac branch from the left recurrent laryngeal now. So these many branches will form the formation of the deep cardiac plexus. Now the branches, very interesting. What are the branches of deep cardiac plexus? Now deep cardiac plexus, as we know, it is divided into the right component and left component, right half and left half. So the branches are also similarly distributed in the right and the left half. First, the branches from the right half. From the right half, the branches once again will be divided in front of pulmonary trunk and behind the pulmonary trunk. So therefore, this level, right pulmonary artery. So this right pulmonary artery, some of the branches from the right half of the deep cardiac plexus will pass in front of the right pulmonary artery, and some of the branches from the right half of the deep cardiac plexus will pass posterior to the right pulmonary artery. Now the branches which are passing in front of the right pulmonary trunk, remember the branches of the right half of the deep cardiac plexus which is passing in front of the right pulmonary trunk, and those branches will be, draw the branches, the first branch. Here I am going to use orange color for the branches, so it will be slightly different. The first branch which will pass in front will be going to the right coronary plexus. Please note down, the first branch from the right half of the deep cardiac plexus in front of pulmonary trunk into the right coronary plexus, branch to right coronary plexus. Second branch will be going in front of pulmonary trunk into the right anterior pulmonary plexus. So very easy to understand, the branches of the right half of the deep cardiac plexus in front of pulmonary trunk will be going to the right anterior pulmonary plexus and right coronary plexus. Now the branches which are going posterior to right pulmonary trunk, the branches of the right half which will go posterior to this, they are, the first branch will be the branch which will pass to the right atrium. So the branch which will pass posterior and supply the right atrium, simply branch to right atrium, and another branch which will pass posterior and it will supply here left coronary plexus. So it is going to supply over here the left coronary plexus. This is another branch going to the left coronary plexus. So the right half branches are completed. Now left half. What are the branches of the left half? From the left half, the branches will be, the first branch will be a communication, it is going to the superficial cardiac plexus. Second branch will be, it will pass to the left anterior pulmonary plexus, left anterior pulmonary plexus, second branch. Third branch will be, it will pass to the left coronary plexus. So in this way, the branches from the left half of the deep cardiac plexus, please note it down, the first branch is going to the superficial cardiac plexus, second branch is going to the left anterior pulmonary plexus, and third branch will be going to the left coronary plexus. From the right half, the branches are divided by right pulmonary trunk into the branches which are present superficial and branches which are present deep to the right pulmonary trunk. The branches which are present superficial to the right pulmonary trunk from the right half will be branched to the right anterior pulmonary plexus and the branch to the right coronary plexus. And the branches which are passing posterior to the pulmonary trunk from the right half will be, one, branch to the right atrium, 2 branch to the left coronary plexus. Similarly, the branches of the left path will be number 1 branch to the superficial cardiac plexus, number 2 branch to the left anterior pulmonary plexus, and number 3 branch to the left coronary plexus. Here we finish the branches. Now what you have to add will be right and left coronary plexus, which is often asked in MCQs or one mark question answer. Please note down. Now here I am going to show on this side here, right coronary plexus. This is the right coronary plexus which I am showing. The right coronary plexus, this one. The right coronary plexus is formed by, or it is going to receive, it is receiving the branches from, please note down, from some part of, here you show it, from partly from superficial cardiac plexus, superficial cardiac plexus, and partly from the deep cardiac plexus. But which part of the deep cardiac plexus? The right half of deep cardiac plexus. This is often asked as one more question answer or MCQ. The right coronary plexus will be formed by the superficial cardiac plexus as well as by branches from the right half of the deep cardiac plexus. And the left coronary plexus, now here I am going to show the left coronary plexus. The left coronary plexus, which I can mark here. This left coronary plexus is formed by, please note down, it is formed by the right and left half of deep cardiac plexus only. So I am going to mark here right and left part of deep cardiac plexus only. Right and left part of deep cardiac plexus only will form the left coronary plexus. Now we come to the applied anatomy. And after applied anatomy, we are going to put in the points about the afferent and efferent nuclei. In the applied anatomy, first point will be, always note down, the atrial and conducting system of the heart. We know the conducting system of the heart, SA node, AV node, and AV bundle, etc., in the right and the left branches. So the atrial musculature and the conducting system of the heart is supplied by both sympathetic and parasympathetic fibers. Whereas the ventricular musculature is supplied only by sympathetic fibers. Now, second point of applied anatomy. In the second point, all the sympathetic and parasympathetic, here we have described the entire sympathetic as well as the parasympathetic coming from the vagi. Now, both the components, sympathetic and parasympathetic components, which form these cardiac plexuses, superficial and deep cardiac plexus, they are having afferent and efferent fibers. They are having afferent and efferent fibers, except the superior cervical sympathetic ganglia, where it will only be composed of the efferent fibers. It will not receive any afferent fibers. Now please come on this side. We come on this side, this part of the board here, so that we are going to draw a flow chart on this side, and that flow chart we are going to show in such a way that we are going to discuss the components which you need to write down. Now here we start with the sympathetic cardiac nerves. Please note down sympathetic cardiac nerves, very simple. This will be composed of afferent as well as efferent fibers. Now afferent fibers, sympathetic cardiac nerves, afferent fibers, they are coming from, what are the cells of origin? The cells of origin in case of afferent will be, please note down, the cells of origin in the afferent component of the sympathetic cardiac nerves will be the, please note down, dorsal nerve root ganglia of T1 to T5 sympathetic ganglia. That is T1 to T5 spinal nerves. So dorsal nerve root ganglia located on T1 to T5 segments of spinal nerves, they will serve as the cells of origin of the afferent component of the sympathetic cardiac nerves. Simple, very simple. And where are the receiving fibers from? They are receiving the fibers from the, remember, from the middle and inferior sympathetic ganglia, middle and inferior cervical sympathetic ganglia, because superior cervical sympathetic ganglia will not have any afferent component, it will only have efferent component. So these fibers are received from the middle and inferior cervical sympathetic ganglia. Then we come to the efferent component of the sympathetic cervical sympathetic cardiac nerves, the efferent component. Now, in the efferent component, the preganglionic, please note down, the preganglionic fibers, where are the nuclei located? The nuclei for the preganglionic fibers for the efferent component will be located in the, please note down, lateral horn cells of T1 to T5 segments of spinal nerve. So from lateral horn cells of the T1 to T5 spinal cord segment, nuclei for the preganglionic fibers of the efferent component of the sympathetic cardiac nerves are located, and therefore the postganglionic, now where will they go? They will go to the superior, middle and inferior cervical sympathetic ganglia from here. Therefore, the postganglionic, please note down, the postganglionic nuclei will be located where? They will be located in the superior, middle and inferior cervical sympathetic ganglia. Please note down. Then we come to the parasympathetic cardiac nerves. Please note down, we are coming to the parasympathetic cardiac nerves. Sympathetic cardiac nerves are over. Now parasympathetic cardiac nerves. Here also we start with afferent. Now in the afferent component of parasympathetic cardiac nerves, we know that the parasympathetic cardiac nerves are supplied by the vagi nerve, right and the left vagi nerve. So afferent component, the cells of origin for the afferent component, they are located in the nodos ganglion. They are located in nodos ganglion. What is the other name of nodos ganglion? It is known as the inferior ganglion, of which nerve? The vagus nerve. So nodos ganglion or inferior ganglion of the nodos or the inferior ganglion of the vagus nerve will serve as the cells of origin of the efferent component of the parasympathetic cardiac nerves. Now we come to the efferent component. In the efferent component, the preganglionic fibers or the preganglionic nuclei, they are located within the, please note down, nucleus ambiguus, and they are located in the dorsal nucleus of vagus nerve. And where are these two nuclei located, nucleus ambiguus and dorsal nucleus of vagus nerve? In medulla oblongata. So this is the, these nuclei will serve as the preganglionic nuclei for the efferent component of parasympathetic cardiac nerve. Similarly, postganglionic, now here the postganglionic will be located, postganglionic nuclei will be located, where they are located? They are located in the cardiac plexus, superficial and deep cardiac plexus, but within the vicinity of SA node as well as AV node. SA node as well as the AV node. Now this table, why it is important? Because this table is mainly asked in one mark question answer or in MCQs. If you understand this table, it is better to remember this table. So here we complete the nerve supply of the heart. Thank you very much.